After dinner time, it's milking time.
This is the milking area?
This is the milking area, and I can show you how we take one from the tarantulas. So what I do here, I have CO2 tank on the side of my table.
Uh-huh.
In those bottles up here, there's the water and the gas going through the bottles that practically show me how much gas each spider's getting. So you hold the tarantula over the lid of plastic tube, put the fangs inside the tube, and then stimulate her fangs, and she will release the venom inside the tube. So when we get some venom, you just kind of suck it up, it's the pipette, and transfer to the vial.
Okay. We're going to sort of anesthetize the spider.
Just partially.
Just a little bit, like put it in a little twilight sleep.
Getting venom from spiders is called milking them. Think of it like going to the dentist. The spiders are anesthetized so they can be handled. The spider doesn't get hurt, and the milker doesn't get bitten.
So you can put her down and then kind of hold her legs, making sure your fingers are over top of her legs. Put her fangs over the tube. And we'll stimulate her. The electricity going through here, and then I have foot pedal on the floor.
Oh.
A tiny jolt of electricity starts the flow of venom.
So you don't do that too many times and you get nice.
The venom from each type of spider is collected in a separate vial.
Okay, you ready to try?
I'm ready. Breathe deep. Breathe. Just let it happen. Let it happen. Let me get the two tubes right in her face. This ought to do it. Might be messing with the wrong spider.
So wait.
Good grief, look at those fangs. Are you kidding? All right.
There's another amount in your venom, so you won't go from the top and stimulate the venom glands are more on the back here. Getting venom? A little bit.
Yeah.
Pull her gently and put her in the big container.
Okay.
Done, not bad at all.
Good. All right, what else can we milk?
We can milk some scorpions. Those guys, we don't put them sleep.
Why?
Because there's no meat. Cover him with the lid.
Scorpions are easier to handle than spiders, so they're milked without anesthesia.
Hold the lid with your left hand.
Okay, here comes the juice, buddy.
I'll push it more up here.
Right here?
Yeah, pedal.
Oh, yeah. You're being milked, my man. Oh, yeah. You've been milked by Mike. Been a while since I milked a widow. Oh, only 30?
Do you need 500 black widows to get one drop of venom?
Oh.
So it's hardly anything in there.
That's one black widow.
That's one black widow.
And where do you
and
put that now?
This can make you extremely sick.
Really?
Will make you feel like your bones are breaking and twisting. Okay. Put her down on the table.
Milking the black widow spider is extremely difficult.
Jeez.
Even picking one up with tweezers is tricky. Too much pressure and the spider is squashed. So Anita trains people to do it using dead spiders. Today she took a chance. Let me use a live one.
I want to get right in there.
You have to twist a little bit. And I'll try
there
we go.
A microscope is normally needed to see the widow's tiny fangs and extract the venom. But Doug has set up a camera so that we can all see it with a monitor.
Well, I'm moving the whole microscope now, wait a minute.
So now you're lifting the pedipalps. No, those are pedipalps. The fangs are.
There.
You're just lifting them right now.
Right.
See?
Yes, that's where I want to be. That's,
yep.
Stop it. Don't fight it. Don't fight it. Wow, this is maddening.
But you don't want to do 800 a day?
No, I don't. I couldn't drink coffee and do this job. Look at me. God, I'm falling apart. Crap. Shut up, Dave. About that?
Nope, that's probably the grudge thing.
Okay.
After my lackluster attempt, Anita stepped in to show me how she milks 800 of these a day.
Okay.
Black Widow, right?
Okay.
There it is. Yeah, a little fang in there. This is very, Doug, I have to say, this is.
You see the venom?
I've been this excited about a shot of yours.
You thought there's a liquid in a container?
Yeah, right there. There's the venom.
Yep.
Oh, I want her angled the other way. I want her like this.
I decided to try my luck with the widow one more time.
And then I want to bring her up here like that.
Mm-mm, you have to, but you have to hold her.
Yep, fangs. Oh, I see the tongue. This is pure zen, this work here. This is the most.
Not waking up. I'll try it anyway.
My last Black Widow also marked the end of the workday. But there was one curious piece of equipment in the lab we hadn't touched yet.
It's in our refrigerator.
That's my freezer for the venom.
Look at this refrigerator.
If I was planning to finish up with a cold one, I came to the wrong refrigerator.
Oh.
This is where Anita and Chuck store the venom they collect. Kept cold, it can remain fresh for up to 30 days.
The fun I could have with this refrigerator. My poor girlfriend would have an absolute stroke. She'd open that thing and that'd be it. That'd be it for me, that'd be it for her. That'd be it for us. It might come out in a clump. If it does, it could be bad. Dave, why don't you place them where you like them? Maybe work that tub of fat in somehow? You know,
hey,
if it looks
hey.
Like it's a, I mean that tub of gold. I mean that, I'm talking about the.
Boy,
I would never suggest
you were. Piss me off first thing, aren't you?
I'm making friends everywhere I go.